I'm trying to make a little video of today's trip, and I used this new camera for the first time, and I just realized that I had it on manual focus, so all the shots for like the first half of this video are going to be out of focus. I apologize. Alright, that was just me literally using you as a backdrop for a clip in a little video. Guys, it's great to be here. Almost didn't make it with the snowstorm yesterday, which is really just horrible, but it's awesome to be here. Today, what I really want to get into with you guys is I want to walk through kind of the trajectory of what has been a very unconventional career path that has led me to where I am today. And the thing that I love most about getting to come and talk to people, this idea that like, no matter how big that view count number is on YouTube, it means nothing. Like, not, you have no idea. But getting to actually come here and like talk to actual human beings instead of just a number is such a gratifying, especially because you have on Snapchat spectacles, nice. It's such like a gratifying experience and something that's so wonderful. And it provides me with an opportunity to share a narrative that I can only ever share pieces of in my videos. And that's why I really cherish these opportunities so, so much. So if I had to give a mission statement for my talk or my biography or for my life, it would be something, I don't know how to say this eloquently, but it's something like, you know where you want to be in life and you know where you are in life, and there really is no one defined path to get there. And I think what we find more often than ever in life is other people or external forces defining paths for us that are presented as the path or the only path. And education, for one, is a path that I think is really something that I was exposed to. Like, you have to go to college, you have to get your degree, and then you have to get your job. Like, that is how you do it. And I think that college is wonderful. Like, my son's in college right now, and he didn't have a choice. That's not fair. He's like bigger than me. Yeah, he could like beat the crap out of me. But I think college is wonderful, but I don't think college is where you get the path defined for you. College is where you get tools to help build your path. I always say that, like, my vision for what I wanted to do, my dreams and aspirations were born in the bottom of like a burnt, disgusting, milky clam chowder pot that I was scrubbing, where like literally like the pot came up to my shirt, and like, you know what that stink smells like when you're scrubbing clam chowder that's been sitting all day in a burnt pot? Doing that for 50 hours a week to support my family as a teenager, like, that is where my motivation, that is where my ambitions, that is where my goals in life were birthed. But I would never say that the only way to find your path in life is to scrub chowder pots. So I bring that up because I think that that path is something that is so undefined that now that I'm an old man, I'm able to look back. Okay, I say that in jest, but I do mean it, that like, I look around, especially in the last 18 months of my life, which have been so transformative, and like, you know, I'm 35 now, but I'm also like a guy who's a married guy with two kids who like lives in a house in New York City, who like doesn't party or drink alcohol or do drugs or really do anything that you would describe as fun, except for maybe every once in a while in the afternoon play like 25 minutes of Call of Duty, only if Sam's next door and will come play with me, and like there's no phone call before or after, and it's not a big deal. But like, I am found in the last year that I am now an adult. And when I think about how I got to this place right now, it has enabled me or forced me to sort of look back at my life and say, how did I possibly get here?